tonight with new developments surrounding an ag tech hub and business park being planned for the heart of the Salinas Valley ag industry. Action News first broke the story about the development during last year's Forbes Ag Tech Summit in Salinas. Today we are learning that plans are changing a bit. With more on the latest developments, we go to Action News reporter Felix Cortez live in Salinas.
Well, Aaron, when Action News first broke that story, the Salinas Airport was the only site being considered for that business park. Today, we learned that the city's public works yard just behind me is now a possible option.
This is what the new Salinas Business Park could look like. Question, where will it be built? When plans were originally announced, the Salinas Airport was the prime choice. But the developer also considering the corner of John N. Work Streets, where the city's public works yard is, an area now considered an opportunity zone that could come with tax breaks.
And that's part of the reason this is so complicated, is that you've got the Ag Tech Park, you've got a public works yard, you've got other potential developments, you've got two different sites. So does this make sense over here, or does that make sense over there?
If the business park were to be built at the city yard, that facility would be moved to the airport. But complicating matters more is that any proposed development on this plot of land just outside the airport requires FAA approval, and it could be months before any decision is made.
And we do have some interested tenants, but the question is one of delivery. When a company is looking to expand, they want certainty that they know when they'd be able to move in. And right now, I can't answer that question for them because I'm not in control of the FAA.
Also changing is who the tenants might be. Original plans called for space to be allocated to research and development for ag tech startups. Now it's looking more like a distribution warehouse and manufacturing facility.
The challenge with the ag startup deal, I mean, we had interest from a couple of different entities that were pretty small and, you know, didn't have a lot of credit behind them. Make it very difficult to finance.
It's a bit challenging because when you're looking at startups, they don't typically sign leases before you build the buildings, which is a bit of a challenge. So we're trying to figure out how to make that work.
Well, bottom line, both city leaders and the developer say this project is moving forward, just not as quick as they would like. Aaron, Dan.
All right, Felix, thank you. The $50 million project could entail roughly a 250,000 square feet of office and warehouse space and could employ nearly 1,000 people.